in some very remote areas like here in Norway, but also in the developing world, aquaculture is like a really important source of employment.
I'm from a small fishing village nearby. Yeah, I've been working, grown up with fish all my life.
My family has been into catching fish and producing fish for generations.
De fleste som går på skolen her, de tar utdanning innenfor naturbruk, aquakultur og fisk- og fangstnæring.
More ladies take higher education and they can't get job when they come back to Skjervøy.
But of course we may have to make sure that these are good jobs, so that the workers are taken care of.
Aquaculture is a more steady way of having work.
I more or less know that I will get biomass, the production will expand.
We regulate ourselves, do we feel safe? And if one of the group doesn't, then we just abort mission.
That they have good working conditions.
We feel naked without both the vest and the helmet. So there's a ladder on the cage. If I were to fall in, I could pull the ring and the ladder will come out and I can climb up again. Without the ladder, it's quite a bit of a job to get up.
Likewise, it's important that there is like good relationships with the communities around the farms.
Vi har relativt ofte møte og dialog med Lerøy, og vi har det samme med fiskerne, og jeg har utfordret. Vi har hatt en sjømatkonferanse.
Vi inviterer folk som bor i områdene til møter, hvor vi belyser hva vi gjør.
We are building a visiting center. When we had to choose where to put the center, we wanted to put it into the high school, because the government have been threatening to close down the school. But by putting our center into the school, we are ensuring that the school will be there. We want to give something back to the community.